Hello, I want you to meet this wonderful family. It's Mary, the mum, Jim, the dad, and Ian, the son. And they're going to help us to understand some key concepts about social mobility. Now, Ian is an accountant, so he will be considered middle class. And if this triangle represents the upper class at the top, middle class in the middle, and lower class at the bottom, he would typically be considered as an accountant to be in the middle class. So what would happen if in Ian's lifetime, he got a series of promotions and ended up as the CEO of this international accounting firm, end up making an absolute boatload of money, and actually joined the upper class? He would actually move up in terms of his social standing. What about on the flip side? What if he had some real struggles at the company, got fired, and ended up in a really poorly paid job, maybe in a manual job, maybe as a factory worker? He would perhaps move down. In his lifetime, he would perhaps join the working class or the lower class. So one of the important things to consider here is what's happening to Ian. It's happening to him in his lifetime, in his own lifetime. Whether he goes up or down, this change in social mobility that he's experiencing is one that it's affecting him in his own generation, in his own lifetime. And this is something that we call intragenerational mobility. And the important thing with intragenerational mobility is that it's affecting Ian in his lifetime. Now, there's another concept I want to introduce you to, and that concept is a little bit different. And that concept is actually called intergenerational mobility. And just like intragenerational mobility, these concepts are both really describing types of social mobility, particularly social mobility up or down the social hierarchy. Now, what's different about intergenerational mobility is that we really need to consider Ian's parents, because intergenerational mobility actually considers them in addition to him. Instead of just looking at what is happening to him, we have to really consider where they stand on the social ladder. So let's have a look at them. So if they were manual workers, laborers, working class or lower class, and then Ian ended up being a CEO, for example, in the upper class, we would see that across generations, there was a change in their social group. From a lower class to upper class. So really, one of the key concepts between both of these is that when we consider intragenerational mobility, we are considering social mobility change in a person's own lifetime. While when we consider intergenerational mobility, we are considering social mobility changes across generations.